This is All India Radio, Shillong. The Northeast News Bulletin, read by Sandeepan Chakravarti. Narendra Modi will be sworn in as country's Prime Minister for the second term on Thursday. President Ramnath Kovind will administer the oath of office and secrecy to Mr. Modi and other members of Union Council of Ministers at a function in Rashtrapati Bhavan. The event will take place in the evening at 7 p.m. AIR correspondent reports that after the landslide victory in the Lok Sabha polls, Mr. Modi has been elected unanimously as the leader of the National Democratic Alliance. The new cabinet of Narendra Modi is expected to have representation of all states and regions, especially from West Bengal and Odisha, where BJP has performed well. Sikkim Governor Ganga Prasad has invited the president of Sikkim Karantikari Morcha, Prem Singh Golay, to form the new government in the state. Prem Singh Golay will take oath as the new Chief Minister of Sikkim along with his Council of Ministers at Palzol Stadium in Gangtok at 10 a.m. today. The oath ceremony will be open to public. Thousands of supporters and party workers are expected to be present in the swearing-in ceremony. The Sikkim party defeated the SDF party, who ruled the state for 25 years under its leader Pawan Chambling as longest service Chief Minister of Sikkim. In 32-member Sikkim Assembly, the Sikkim won 17 seats while the SDF secured 15 seats. Arunachal Pradesh unit of the National People's Party has elected Mutchu Mithi as its legislature party leader. The legislature party meeting of NPP Arunachal Pradesh was held at the NPP National Office, New Delhi, yesterday under the chairmanship of its national president and Meghalaya Chief Minister Conrad K. Sangma. The NPP state president, Gichu Kabak, Meghalaya Home Minister James Sangma, Emirates Mutchu Mithi, Tapuk Taku, Gokar Basar and other senior leaders of the party attended the meeting. The Centre for Development of Northeastern Region of Indian Institute of Management, IIM Shillong, and Good World Foundation have submitted a white paper to Meghalaya Deputy Chief Minister Preston Tensong on the burgeoning traffic congestion in Shillong, which includes recommendations on how to address the problem. Stating that the recommendations are both for long and short-term solutions, the centre said that improvement of traffic congestion started by touching upon essential policy framework of the government relating to public transport and its allied issues such as road capacity, expansion, parking facility enhancement. The centre will participate and contribute to the government efforts to improve the traffic situation in Shillong City if the need arises, for providing more clarity to the recommendations and approaches. The newly elected Member of Parliament from Nagaland, Tokeho Yeptomi, has justified the Citizenship Amendment Bill 2016 and rejected the allegation launched the Nagaland Pradesh Congress Committee President K. Thiri, and maintained that the issue has been misconstrued and has become a propaganda tool. In a statement, Tokeho clarified that the issue has been wrongly put in the public domain, that once CAB is passed, the entire Northeast region will be overrun by crores of immigrants waiting at the borders of neighbouring countries. Assam filmmaker Dhritiman Kakati's short documentary film, The Man Who Speaks Nature, bagged the Best Film Award at the 5th International Nature Film Festival, Godollo, from May 23rd to May 27th at Godollo, a town in Hungary. The Man Who Speaks Nature had earlier been screened in many prestigious film festivals. Another US-based filmmaker, musician, singer and songwriter, originally from Assam's Jorhat, Rupam Sharma, One Little Finger received the world's largest honor for video and TV content, with 3 awards in music, direction and social awareness in the 40th annual Telly Awards in the United States recently. 2 Assam Rifles personnel were killed and 4 others sustained injuries in an ambush by suspected NSC and K militants from across the border on Saturday in Mon district of Nagaland. Improvised explosive device was triggered at a location between Tobu and Uka, about 4 km north of Tobu, as a team of 40th Assam Rifle soldiers were patrolling in the area. Nagaland Chief Minister Nephew Rio condemned the attack on Assam Rifles personnel by unidentified persons. And with that, we end the Northeast News Bulletin from All India Radio. Shillong. Have a nice day.